Hello everyone, it's Rohit. Welcome back to another exciting video on React Native and Expo. Today I have a short and simple tutorial for you on how to create animations in React Native and Expo. Specifically, I will show you how to make an animated digital clock. To begin, let's start a new Expo project and choose the blank template. Name your application and proceed with the downloading of dependencies. Since we won't be using any third-party libraries for this project, we can dive straight into the code. I personally prefer coding in a separate files, so let's create a source folder and inside that create a JavaScript file named index.js. Now let's import index.js and run the application to ensure our project setup is correct and all components are imported successfully. First, we need to import a few essential components from the React Native package as well as the useState and useEffect hooks from the React library. In this code, I am using the useState hook to set up the initial and setter states for time and setTime. Additionally, I will be using morph and glow animations which will both be incorporated into the useState hook. If you are unfamiliar with how the useState hook works, I recommend checking out a video I made a few days ago. It will definitely help you understand it better. In this code, we use the useEffect hook in React to establish an interval that updates the current time every second. It starts by creating an interval with setInterval which calls the setTime function with a new date object every 1000 milliseconds. The useEffect hook is provided with an empty array as a dependency, indicating that it should only run once when the component is mounted. Finally, it returns a cleanup function that clears the interval when the component is unmounted. Similarly, this code employs the useEffect hook to trigger two animation functions, namely animate morphing and animate glowing when the component mounts. By providing an empty array as the second argument, the effect will only run once, mimicking the behavior of the component did mount lifecycle method in class components. Next, we define a function called animateMorphing that utilizes the animated API to create a looping animation. This animation alters the morph animation value from 0 to 1 over a duration of 1 second and then back from 1 to 0 over another 1 second. The useNativeDriver option is set to false, indicating that the animation will be handled by JavaScript rather than the native driver. Finally, the animation is started with the start method. The morph style object specifies the border radius of an element based on the morph animation. The animation interpolates between three values 0, 0.5, 1 and maps them to corresponding border radius value 0, 100, 0. The interpolate colors variables define a color animation, glow animation. This animation interpolates between three values 0, 0.5, 1 and maps them to corresponding RGBA color value red, green, blue. The animated style object sets the color of an element color based on the interpolate colors animation. Lastly, the code returns a view with a container style styles.container that holds a text element with a title style styles.title. Within the container, there is an animated view with a clock container style styles.clockContainer and the morph style applied to it. Inside the animated view, we have an animated text with the animated styles applied, displaying the current time. I must say our animation for the digital clock looks really cool. That's all for this video. If you found it informative, please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. I will see you in the next React Native Expo video.